ICT and National Guidance Minister Chris Bariomonsi's remarks okaying the Nyege Nyege Festival were in response to the communication by Speaker Anita Among, who revealed that there was a meeting between her and Prime Minister Robin Anabanja, but Parliament was still not persuaded to shift its position on banning the Nyege Nyege on moral grounds. The Speaker emphasized that she is embarrassed at mentioning the name Nyege Nyege, despite pronouncing the word for two consecutive days the matter has been in Parliament.
On whatever is happening. Yesterday we heard there was a statement from Honorable Lumumba on what is happening. Some of us are even ashamed of mentioning the names. On that one that is happening outside there. This afternoon we had a meeting with the team from executive. Of course, the team and the meeting was not meant to persuade us to get out of our position. We are still in our position as legislature. We are still there. But what is to be done is the role of executive. For us, we've given our position as a legislature that we are not in for whatever is happening, that one there. So it is left to executive.
Ladies and gentlemen, honorable members, as parliament, when we pronounce ourselves on a matter, executive, we work together with, must listen to us, because we are the choices of the people who are representing them here in this house. Therefore, it is not better if Parliament pronounces against such an event and the cabinet, okay, it goes ahead to look to be supporting, because there are information in media saying executive has already endorsed this.
Minister Bariomonsi, in his response, revealed that government is making regulations on how the Nyege Nyege Festival will be conducted.
And we did agree that there is a need for strong regulation, regulation being a function of the executive. And we continue to consult, and we agreed the executive will handle this matter. So we beg that you give us time, we are handling as executive. And
honorable ministers, Parliament cannot act in total exclusivity. This is government. It is Parliament, the executive, the legislature, that there are three arms of government. So once Parliament has made a position, it is you now as the executive to see how you put in place measures to put it into effect. But when the outside world is seeing us and seeing Parliament taking a position, and somehow it is being debated, and the executive, you seem to be on your own, you seem to be above the position of Parliament, and that is very dangerous, honorable ministers. You can do everything you can in your offices. Please don't run down this institution called Parliament.
Tororo District Woman MP Sarah Opendi fired back at the minister at saying it is government's responsibility to promote Uganda's culture, values and morals, and efforts to ban Nyege Nyege have been futile so far. Opendi added that there is need for government to stop making excuses for such festivals.
What I want to achieve, because government looks determined to have this Nyege Nyege festival. We, the executive, we cannot fight with the executive. In the spirit of harmony, let's allow government to do its part. For us, we have made our stand. And right honorable speaker, the motion that I want to move is that moving forward, because the excuse being given is that it is just a week too. The other year when Father Lokodo was fighting, it is one day too. So can we ban Nyege Nyege from taking place in this country, right honorable speaker? This is the motion that I want to move. We have other means of promoting tourism as a country, right honorable speaker. We've just had the Karamoja Cultural Festival. We've had the Bugisu Cultural Festival. You have not had these controversies. The controversies are coming out because of what has been taking place at these festivals. So this is the motion, Right Honourable Speaker, that I want to move.
Our motto clearly states, for God and my country. Nyege Nyege is a controversial festival. In a country where we are cultivating youths who are supposed to work and from their sweat, you are telling me we are going to have a party for 24 hours? What has this country gotten into? Instead of getting initiatives and symposiums for our youth.
The members of parliament also asked government to clearly state its position on festivals in Uganda, pointing out that whereas there are some artists allowed to hold music concerts in Uganda, others, like former presidential candidate Robert Kyagulanyi, are banned from holding concerts.
And we need Sunday in our country. If Nyege Nyege is to be organized properly, let them invite married people with their spouses and with a clear dress code. But to tell us that you can go naked and enjoy Nyege Nyege. I've even seen some videos, people naked. I don't know whether they are from Uganda because I see so many foreigners.
Meanwhile, on visiting the Nyege Nyege site earlier today, officials from Busoga Kingdom, led by the Kingdom Minister of Tourism, Helen Namutamba, revealed that Busoga Kingdom supports the Nyege Nyege Annual Festival, which they describe as the biggest annual tourism event in the country.
This festival is so safe. There is nothing like immorality, there is nothing like vandalizing people's property. There is nothing like all whatever they have talked about. The place is safe. This place is big. It has been protected. We've got where people are going to sleep. I think the media will be able to show the public.
Clinton Munaba, the head of safety at the event, said they are prepared for the event and many divers are already there to provide any emergency rescue services on the water.
But before we have been five. Because I've been overseeing the scuba divers here and the tubing here, Vitanda tubing, which you're opening. We have been using 5 per day and there's no problem. But then here on this event, we have to increase to 50. Each safety spot, just have a diver, a kayak rescue diver, and then we also have a fully dressed marine diver.
Report by Fred Kajubi and Ivan Dobega for the news.